بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على مولانا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear colleagues and friends, excellencies, distinguished guests, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And good morning, good afternoon or good evening to all of you wherever you are. On behalf of CBAFI and ICD, we have the pleasure of welcoming you to this webinar on open banking, driving force for the financial services industry and Islamic finance. I would like first to thank our colleagues and friends and my friend Ayman Sijini, the CEO of ICD and ICD, for partnering with CBAFI on this important event, and which is actually the first of a series of other webinars that we will be addressing on important issues related to Islamic finance and the financial sector in general, and which will have or is having already a significant impact on Islamic banks operations and financial sector in general. I mean, as we have seen over the last year and this year, we have seen a significant acceleration of the digitalization due to the pandemic situation, which brought very deep and high challenges to all sectors of the economy. But again, the financial sector had to respond in a timely manner and very aggressively, because that's the engine of the economy, which has to facilitate the lives of people and the corporations, SMEs, and so on. So I think we have seen probably a fast implementation of a number of initiatives. Some of them that were planned for the next 3 to 5 years, they were all brought forward and started already now. Some of the areas perhaps that we see and we think have an impact, already are having an impact, or will be having more, and this impact perhaps has been accelerated, is the, of course, for instance, the open banking, which is very important, that started a few years already, which presents a lot of opportunities, but as well as challenges for those that do not engage in this. So we'll be hearing from our speakers, guest speakers, about this, and they would like to take this opportunity to thank them very warmly for sharing with us their insights and making the time for this webinar. The second area perhaps which we, there is already some use, and this use will be increased, is probably the artificial intelligence, machine learning, which has seen significant improvements and advances. And the implementation in the financial sector has started in many big corporations and is improving again. And more importantly also, we have seen that, and we hear some of from like global bodies, that central banks and regulators started also implementing this in their supervision approaches and regulations. So over time, this probably will have also some significant impact on Islamic banks and financial sector as well, in both in various areas, in terms of customer experience, in terms of operations, streamlining operations, credit scoring, fraud detection, anti-money laundering, and so on. And I think that one of the perhaps the emerging challenges to the financial sector industry is something which is at the start now, but will probably for the next 5 years will have some significant impact, and which is the central bank digital currencies. Maybe 1 year, 1 year and a half now, once Facebook had their plan for the Libra currency, so many of the central banks started again looking at this issue on the digital currencies. And globally now, probably over, there was a study by the Financial Stability Board, over 80% of the central banks, they are either doing trial pilot studies or at least doing research on this. We have seen the Central Bank of Europe just closed a public consultation on this issue 1 month or 2 months ago, and asking the public what they think about this. And they are preparing now their plan and strategy for this, In the region as well, Saudi Arabia and UAE, they have done actually a pilot work on this, and there is talk now between UAE and China to have something also for cross-border transactions. So I think this again, we see it globally. It's a new phenomenon that is happening and will certainly have some significant impact on the financial sector. And of course, the Islamic banks are not immune to this as well. I mean, in view of all these changes, of course, we must, as Sivafi, be interested and involved in what is happening in this sector. And this is where we try to raise awareness on these potential issues. And we have got the approval of the board of directors to establish an innovation and technology working group that will be working on all these new trends on artificial intelligence uses for the Islamic banks, blockchain, and many, many others. And of course, one of the initiatives is the partnership we are having with our ICD colleagues to be working on a number of streams, including webinars and probably some other research that will address some of these important challenges. So I'm looking forward to hearing from our guest speakers on their deep knowledge on this topic and to see what as Islamic banks should be doing, should be taking care of right now to be able to follow what's happening. So before finishing, I would like just again to thank our colleagues from ICD, my friend Ayman Sijini, and all the speakers, and thanks to all of you for attending with us. Thank you.